Yes, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Anoop KR. I'm a forest officer and I've been working in various parts of India for the last 16 years. And I will briefly mention about two cases where ecotourism has been effectively used for improvement of social and economic conditions of marginalized people. First part is from Rajasthan, which is in northwestern India. The place is Bharatpur Kevladev National Park, where thousands of migratory birds arrive during winter, and it is located in the center of the Asian bird flyway. I call this tourism as livelihoods in motion. A group of men who arrived in Bharatpur during the partition of India. For them, a program was started as early as 1980, where the tourists arriving to watch birds in the sanctuary were taken around by these local men in their rickshaws. And initially it was a crude form of transportation, but gradually these men developed keen skills of bird watching by interaction with the tourists. They are mostly uneducated men, but they are excellent bird watchers as on today. They keep on learning by their interaction with tourists. Today they can speak as many as 4 to 5 foreign languages, including Japanese, German, French. Not only speak, they can tell the names of birds in these languages as well. And the park administration keeps on sharpening their skills by periodic trainings and improvements in the structure of the rickshaws, providing uniforms and some trainings in the hospitality and visitor interactions. We consider this as the best mode of transportation in a bird watching trail. Whatever improvements we suggested in the form of introducing solar powered rickshaws or golf cars were opposed by the rickshaw pullers themselves, because they say that the control they get in the speed, the noise free ambience that creates, everything is unique in the rickshaw, and they are very happy in pulling the rickshaws along the trails. Some of the rickshaw pullers have handed over their licenses to their siblings. They take a great pride in their knowledge and of the park and its ecology. The rickshaw pullers have a kind of ownership, sense of ownership for the park. They think that this park is theirs, and to keep it clean and to behave nicely with the tourists, all will add to their business, their mode of living. Some of them have received international recognition. The group as a whole has been recognized by the Lonely Planet. Some of the rickshaw pullers have their children abroad. They are from very marginal part of the society. They have come to the mainstream. Now being portrayed as a group of that can give us an example of social and economic development through ecotourism in the northwestern India. You don't find any other such example. Their sense of ownership to the park is reflected in their voluntary activity in managing the park as well. Whenever there is a removal of invasive species, they offer their help voluntarily. In the pictures you can see the water hyacinth and the catfish, the invasive African catfish, are removed by the rickshaw pullers. In every rickshaw you can find a box kept under the seat that is for picking the plastic bits of plastic or other trash thrown by the tourists. So this they also discipline the tourists. They ensure that the rules of the park are followed. And that was about Bharatpur. Now I'll move to the southernmost part of India, which is Periyar Tiger Reserve, where a group of poachers, a group of men who used to be involved in smuggling of sandalwood and the poaching and the cultivation of ganja, marijuana, they were transformed and brought into the mainstream through ecotourism. In the initial phase, there was a lot of difficulties in bringing them to a platform for dialogues. Some of the forest officers, dedicated forest officers, managed to do that, and they were willing to give up their crimes involving the theft and poaching, but they are not accepted in the society, and they, without any other options in their hand, they are continuing with the risky job of being a poacher. The forest department offered them that if they give up what they are doing, the offense cases registered against them will be withdrawn, but they have to agree that they will not involve in such activities anymore. So they asked the question, what will we do? The forest department had an answer for that. Initially, they were organized. 23 poachers were organized into a committee, and minor repair and maintenance works of the park were given to them. But that was not sufficient to meet their livelihood requirements. Then a very adventurous tourism program called Periyar Tiger Trail was started. The idea was that these poachers, they were very good at navigation in the forest during day as well as night. They knew every track. They knew the behavior of every animal. They know how to move without any danger in the forest. So that skill was used in taking tourists along a trail, an imaginary trail that was the routes of the poachers. And in the safe locations where the poachers used to camp in the jungle, they were converted as camping locations for the tourists. And this was an instant hit in the tourism industry. It is about 16 to 17 years after we started this program. And till date, not even a single tourist was harmed by any wild animal in Periyar during these years. They were also mostly uneducated people, but with constant interactions with the tourists and with the trainings of the forest department, they developed basic skills of natural history and about the birds and animals of the forest. As promised, forest department withdrew all the offense cases against them, and the members of this group, they are working hands in hand, hands to shoulders with the forest department. And today, if you look in the in the list of the best tourism programs in India, this will definitely be one among the 10 best ecotourism programs. They have been recognized internationally as well as nationally by various awards. Extra hours of protection to the park was another unintended result of this program. Moving of uniformed men in the deep inside the forest was adding to the protection hours put in by the staff. And once these men were looked upon as menace in the society, they were their children were not allowed to study in the good schools. All these social stigma were removed when they became part of the park of the ecotourism program. And some of the members, they even went on to become elected representatives in the local self-government. And we proudly say that the second string of protection of Periyar Tiger Reserve is this ex-poachers. And the management's intervention in keeping a part of money they earned through this program as a reserve money, that is what helped them in surviving these times of crisis in tourism industry due to the COVID-19. Apart from the Tiger Trail, the tourism programs were diversified by involving more men from adjoining the Tiger Reserve, who are almost equally marginalized or from the poverty-ridden villages. And all these programs are running very well, and about 400 people are directly benefiting from the ecotourism in this Tiger Reserve. I'm limiting to my time, otherwise I could have more programs and more slides to show. Thank you very much for your attention.